Oh, you made it. Welcome to Steel City, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. So you're here for a weekend. So what are you gonna do? I'll walk you through an itinerary of Saturday and Sunday of the best things to do and see here in Steel City, Steel Town. So let's get into it with our first stop. It feels so good, loving you. Yeah, it's all good, the way you do the do. Okay, first up is the Strip District, you might have guessed it. I did a video on this 2 weeks ago. I'll put the link right here so you can check that out. But come here Saturday morning to kick off your day. There's so much going on, so many people out and about. It's just a place where it's hard to get bored. So come here to start your day. And to start your day, you'll wanna get a great breakfast at DeLuca's right here behind me. They serve up one of the best breakfasts in Pittsburgh, so start off there. You can also go to Cafe Raymond right here if you choose. And there's a lot of different coffee shops as well. La Prima, Allegheny Coffee Tea Exchange. There's just a lot to offer here. So start your day with a great breakfast, a coffee to energize you to get ready for a long day ahead. So this is the Strip District. So now let's head on over to the next location on what you need to see when coming to Pittsburgh for the weekend. I'm going there, and I swear I can get enough of you. Okay, so number two on my list is Point State Park. So this is where all three rivers meet in the center of Pittsburgh. You're probably familiar with the look of it on the map. It's the very tip of the city with the fountain right here behind me. So the Point is usually an action-packed place on a nice day. You'll see a lot of people out here on bikes, running, just getting some exercise in. There's a lot going on as well on the water with boats out, especially today on a beautiful day. So it's probably the most touristy place on my list today, but it's still one of my favorite places to come to in Pittsburgh. I end almost every single one of my bike rides down here, just sitting and taking in all the scenes of the three rivers and just enjoying the nice weather. So on the list today, definitely try to make it to the Point. You won't regret it. So this is the Point. Now let's head just a short walk away to spot number three on our list of things to do for a weekend in Pittsburgh. Okay, once you're finished at the Point, walk back into the city and come here to Market Square. I know it might also be touristy, but it's a great place to come, get an early afternoon drink, happy hour, and try one of the restaurants down this way. You can go to City Works behind me, Primanti Bros, not very good, but good place to grab a drink. They also have Chipotle, Moe's, fast food, but don't go there. Go to a local business and get a happy hour, and then make your way to any place in the downtown area for dinner. Okay, so moving on to dinner on Saturday. So I'll recommend any one of these places in the downtown area to go to. So first up is the best restaurant in Pittsburgh, Gaucho. You can find a link to my video covering the whole restaurant right here. So if you can't get a table there, you can go further down the road to Condado Tacos. Not a bad place to get some good Mexican food. Or you can go to Bakersfield, another place close by, which is pretty good. And I would also recommend The Yard in Market Square, another pretty good place. After that, let's head on back to your hotel or wherever you are in Pittsburgh to conclude the day, and let's move on to Sunday and get into what you need to do on day two of your time here in Pittsburgh. Same song to a different beat. It's really sometimes I feel like I'm the only one here. Okay, so to start off your Sunday, I would recommend coming over here to Shadyside. This is one of the cooler little neighborhoods in Pittsburgh. Now you can find any of the cool little spots to get a nice breakfast to start off your day. They of course have the typical coffee shops. They have some art festival going on right now, as you can see here. all the way down the main street here. But this is what I'm talking about. They have all kinds of events over this way. It's just a great place to come on a morning and Sunday to check out and see all the cool little shops. So come here in the morning on Sunday. Now we'll head over to spot number two on the list of things to do Sunday. So let's head over. Back. I had a dream that the whole world was staring at me. I woke up and wasn't no one there. Okay, so after you finish up over in Shadyside, come over here to Schenley Park, as you can see right here behind me. This is a great place to come to escape the hustle and bustle of the city. There's a lot to do over here. You can go up, play tennis, walk around the park, have a picnic, just spend some time in the outdoors with whoever you're in Pittsburgh with. It's also pretty close to Oakland, Pitts campus. You can check that out. Don't recommend, go Penn State, much better. But that's another story. So yeah, come over here to Schenley Park to escape into the outdoors. So let's head over to our third place here to go to on Sunday. So zoom over there. What you say to me ain't guaranteed to always be the gospel. I was doing good way before I met you. Now you're off the set and I'ma let you see the show go on without you. Take a bow. Okay, next up on our list is Mount Washington. One of the best views in Pittsburgh. Just feels like you're sort of on top of the city, which is pretty cool. And if you've never been to Pittsburgh, I do recommend coming up here, even though it is a pretty touristy place. But that's okay, nothing to be shameful of in that. Now, if you want to avoid the tourists altogether, you can head over to the West End to pretty much avoid all of the tourists. That is another option. But here at Mount Washington, it is probably a more accessible place. They have these lookout points right here, which are perched up on side of the hill, which is nice to get out and take some pretty cool pictures. It's definitely closer to the city than the West End, and the views are pretty much the same. I mean, it's either or, you can't really go wrong with each. Now transitioning into the night, you can either stay up here on Mount Washington. There's a cool little neighborhood if you head off of the main street here, which has some pretty nice restaurants. You can go grab a drink there, or you could come here to the Southside, one of the most action-packed places in all of Pittsburgh, probably the most action-packed place in Pittsburgh. There are so many bars, so many restaurants on East Carson Street. I mean, it'll take you years to go to all of them. So definitely come here for a night out. If you want to go out both nights, come here both nights. It really is the best of the best here. You can't even begin to explain how many bars and restaurants and activities, action there is in the South Side. So I know I can't show it all right now in the middle of the day, but once the sun goes down, the people come out, floods of people. It's really a great place to be. And the South Side is also where I live. So if you're ever down in the South Side and want to stop by, say hi, the door is always open. Just let me know. So that concludes the video today. Hopefully this gives you more of a clear idea of what you can do in a weekend here in Pittsburgh. So thanks as always for watching, and we'll see you next week for yet another Pittsburgh video. So stay tuned. From the rooftop, what's gonna make my fall? I think I might go on and on.